What's up, everyone? I'm excited to talk to you today about 7-Eleven.
Why'd you stop?
I thought that was my only line. Welcome, ProPresenter family. I'm Jeremy Grono, Director of Software Operations here at Renewed Vision, and I'm excited to share with you today some of the features and improvements we've made for our latest release, 7.11. 7.11 is officially our fourth feature release in the past 12 months, and our team has been hard at work keeping up with the pace of these releases to provide a number of new features and stability updates to help you and your team tell your stories. Like many of you watching, our team is made up of production volunteers, tech directors, graphics operators, production managers, and worship leaders. We're in the trenches every single week using ProPresenter just like you. We want to ensure that we stay current on live production needs, and right here in Atlanta this week, our team used the Stream Deck and the ProPresenter API to control graphics, clocks, and audio announcements at a corporate event. But it's not about us. We love hearing your stories too. Just this last month, we've heard stories of how a church in Texas had an elementary student who was excited that he got to learn how to use ProPresenter and serve at his church. And in California, how Stanford University used ProPresenter at their conference to stream a virtual stage display back to their presenters who were joining in across the country. We truly believe that this ProPresenter community is filled with some of the most talented individuals from tens of thousands of organizations all over the world. To tell us more about what you can expect in 7.11, we have Amanda joining us from our product management team. She's been reviewing user feedback every single day to make sure that we are continuously delivering value to you, our users.
Hi everyone, I'm Amanda Kongvold. And like Jeremy said, our team has been working very hard to deliver a stable and reliable product that is jam-packed with features. Today, I'm excited to show off a brand new feature in our editor and some workflow improvements that are being introduced in 7.11. So let's get started. First, I'd like to start in a state that I'm sure many of you have found yourself in. I have this new media background that I really like, but when I show the text, it's kind of hard to read. I don't necessarily want to just add a colored box behind it, and I don't really want to do a shadow. I really want this text to be incorporated with the background. So this is where our new feature, background effects, comes in. Background effects are a new type of object fill that can be used to either blur or invert the content coming from the background media or a video input. This can be used to create many cool effects as well as help your slides fit more naturally into the background, whether it be pre-rendered media or over live video. So let's start by adding a background effect fill to a theme. I already have a theme here that I'm going to open in the editor. I already have formatted my text the way I want it, but again, as we saw, text alone is not going to look very good. So I'm going to add a background blur fill. How I do this is I come over to the shape tab, I'm going to add a fill. The default is color, so I'm gonna click on this selector and come to our new option of background effect. You'll see there are two options. There's a background blur and a background invert. For this first example, I'm gonna do background blur. After I select background blur, I have the options to adjust the saturation and the amount of blur. Since I want the object to pop quite a bit, I'm going to increase the saturation amount to make it more saturated than the background. Then I'm going to increase the blur amount so that the text can really be legible against this background. Now that my theme is set, I'm going to return to my presentation in the show view. But before I continue, I'm going to keep you in suspense for a moment to highlight our new theming workflow. You'll notice that all of my available themes can be viewed here. If I want to create a new theme, I simply click the Add button in the top right. If I hover over a theme thumbnail and move my mouse left and right, I can also preview the thumbnails of all theme slides included within a theme. If I want to further see everything included in a theme, I can simply select the thumbnail and view all the theme slides. From here, I can edit the theme by clicking the edit icon, rename or delete theme slides, or apply the theme slide to whichever queue or presentation I have selected. Now, to continue with the theme I made a moment ago, which is my new theme right here, I will make sure I'm in the presentation I want the theme to be applied to. Then I go to the theme, select the theme slide I created, and that theme is now applied to my presentation. If I wanted to change my mind and select a different theme slide from within the theme, I just click on the theme button and I'm able to select one of those here. If I want a completely different theme, I can click this back button and I'm back to be able to browse all the themes that I have available. But now that my theme is applied, let's see how the background blur helped my text stand out from the background media. Everything looks legible and the lyrics really pop now. The lyrics are still embedded within the media, but you're able to read them very easily. There's also an option for background invert. Here, I have a countdown that looks all right, but I want it to stand apart from the background a bit more and get a little bit more stylized. I created this theme earlier that has a rectangle shape with a background invert fill. After I apply that theme to this countdown and re-trigger the cue, you'll see how that rectangle shape is inverting the colors of the background, making things really pop and be a bit more stylized. These background effects also work with video inputs, so if you're sending lyrics or other content to your live stream, you can be sure that no matter how busy the stage may be behind your presenter or worship leader, what you're sending will always stand out. We hope these additions inspire you and benefit your specific workflow. With these improvements and the ones coming in future releases, we want to make sure the ProPresenter gives you the most potential for use and creativity. So make sure to share in the ProPresenter users Facebook group some ideas of how your organization is using these features. We always love seeing the amazing work you do. You never know how your creativity can inspire someone else.
We're excited to see how you are able to use these new features in your own presentations. 7.11 will be available soon as a public beta for all ProPresenter Plus members to get their hands on and test these new features in their own environments. For anyone watching who may be a ProPresenter 6 user, we want to thank you for being a part of the ProPresenter family. Beginning January 31st, 2023, ProPresenter 6 will be reaching its end of life and will no longer be supported. Before that date, we're offering a discount price for ProPresenter 6 users who choose to upgrade to ProPresenter 7. We truly believe that ProPresenter 7 is filled with features and functionality that will help you and your organization in so many different ways. I encourage you to visit our website and download a free 14-day trial of ProPresenter 7 to see exactly what I'm talking about. I hope you've enjoyed learning about what our team has been working on, and we can't wait to see how you use these new features of ProPresenter to better allow you to share the stories that change the world.